Hello, it's Thomas, and do you see what I have here? The new YUMi C235, which is a color 3D printer, which can provide up to 12 colors, which is quite a lot, multiple size. This is currently on Kickstarter only for a few days left. You have multiple options, like I said, different sizes, and they raise almost $400,000, which is quite great for a small company. And then about the printer, we'll discover it, of course, and you see the head is on metallic rails. You have quite thick belts, you have an auxiliary fan, of course tensioners, you can plug any type of cameras, and everything is based on this smart pad, which is a Linux board running a Clipper and Clipper screen. You have very basic options for beginners and of course advanced options and features. And now comes the color part, which is based on this YMS, which is YUMi material system. You can plug, you see here, 5 of them, up to 12. You see the head is different, and it's you can't compare that to other color system on filament printers. Of course, you have a cutter, but it's working without a cutter with the default Chroma 12 head. Now let's see some print. Obviously, I started with the classical Benchy, which was quite nice, but was lacking some cooling on the front part. Then I just changed the default profile just to increase the fan power, and the result was very, very good. Now another just test again, just to see if all the 5 colors were working fine. I just did a flat cube, and in Orca slicer, which is the default slicer, I painted the 5 colors, did my print, and result was very clean. It was working fine. Now let's do a real 3D model. You see this spider created by Matt Meyer Makes. I put the link in the description of the video. And of course I had to wait a little bit because I have 5 colors, a change of color for almost each layers, and you see the result, which is really, really nice. You see 10 hours and 50 minutes for this type of models in multiple color. This is quite fast, I have to say. And now I just did another model. In fact, this is a 3D model I created myself. You can move the eyes, and also it has 5 colors. And in fact, 5 colors is great because you need most of the time white and black color, then 3 extra colors. Then the print is moving forward. You can see the poop on the side, but I will speak about that. The filament I'm using are the YUMi filaments. They have a large array of colors, which is really, really great. I really like this filament. By the way, I use a few skin option in Orca slicer, and after 14 hours and 29 minutes I had my result. Very, very clean prints, and like I said, you can move the eyes to really design the model that way. The fuzzy skin give kind of interesting textures. Another example of model I did with the printer, I just did one small Labubu duck, and just to do this timing between the change of colors. You see you have on the left the beige to orange, and orange to beige, then the other side on the right part of the screen. This is real time. It's really to show you that changing a color can take roughly 30-40 seconds, depending of course of the colors. And if you compare to other printers, it can take up to 2 minutes and sometimes 3 minutes, depending of the printer. And that's why the change of color of colors is very, very quick. And of course you save quite a lot of time on your multicolor prints, meaning that now I just switched to a multiple version of this small duck. Again, I put the link of this on the description, and after not that so long I had multiple of them. I increase a lot the speed to have something very, very quickly, as quickly as possible, and had great result. Another example, which is this can holder, I'm not very sure about the name in English, same with 4 color this time, just to do something which is quite big. And also I did that as fast as possible, and the result also is very, very nice, to print not only quickly the change of color but also the printing speed, and you see that the result is really great. Now another project, which is the Son Goku U-Forge that I just downloaded, and I put again the link in description, which is which has 5 colors, this orange, black obviously, this blue, this beige, and this white color. You see the first layer is really, really nice with the printer, and of course the result is just amazing. And then imagine printing U-Forge on the C435 with 12 colors, it should be just fantastic. And now let's talk a little bit about the poops. It you seem that you have a lot. In fact, not that much. You see for this print, 74 grams, the poops 138, which is a little bit more than the white of the print because you have a lot of color of changes. For this one, you see you have in fact less poops, than the print. And if you look, of course, at the overprint, which will be almost the same, if you look at other printers, most of the time you have a lot. And you see for this other 3D printers, which is very similar, the difference in white between the 3D print and the poops. Of course, you have other brands which are selling more colors, I will say, like Creality with their CFS. You can plug up to 4 CFS per printer, but to 99 euros per CFS, it's quite expensive. Okay, let's come back to the printer. Just below the smart pad, you have the hyperdrive, which is where you connect the YMS 5 per hyperdrive, and you can plug up to 2 hyperdrive and 2 extra YMS on the printer, than 12 colors. And of course, you can use a direct drive head, which is way more faster, but you lose the aspect of the multiple colors. In terms of maintenance, the head is quite easy. The components are quite, let's say, standard. Except the nozzle. The nozzle is really, really specific to the printers, and obviously you have access to the full part of Clipper with the printer settings and so on. Also about the stability, people are asking questions. In fact, the printer is quite stable, and if you look at Nicola really on top of the printer I tested, and this is the same printer, this is quite impressive. Nicola White is 80 kilograms. And I forgot to mention that, of course, you have a mobile application, which is quite convenient. You can do everything, including monitoring with the camera. And these are some extra prints. In fact, the YUMi team gave me this print made with the same printer I tested, which are quite cool, to be honest. Small, biggest one, which really showcases what the printer is able to do, and it's really, really great. But while the hardware looks really promising, the software part needs to be polished, and for sure with the remaining month they have before the delivery of the printer, they should be able to deliver a great product. Now, of course, if you have questions, let me know in the comments. Thank you, bye-bye.